If you've ever been lucky enough to look up and see bright lights dancing across the night sky, you're familiar with one of the planet's most dazzling natural displays, the auroras. And for a long time, these light shows were pretty mysterious. But the late physicist Joan Feynman helped us understand the origin of these light shows. She also figured out that they can reveal clues about the sun, as well as about the surprising connections between our planet and the star we orbit. Joan Feynman was born in 1927 in Queens, New York. You may already recognize her last name and associate it with science, and that's no coincidence. Her brother was Richard Feynman, one of the most famous physicists of the 20th century. But before he was a famous physicist, he was a brother. And he would often talk with his younger sister about science. He was the one to take her out to a golf course near their house in Queens to see her first aurora when she was 5 or 6. What neither of them knew at the time was that this experience would later inspire her career, in particular, the decade she would spend working on the physics underlying auroras. After graduating with a PhD in solid-state physics from Syracuse University in 1958, Joan Feynman got to work, trying to understand what drives these polar light shows. For about 100 years, astronomers had suspected a link between the sun's activity and auroras. In 1859, they spotted a huge solar flare. And then, 2 days later, telegraph wires started heating up and bright auroras extended as far south as the Caribbean and Hawaii. But it wasn't until we started sending scientific instruments to space on satellites in the 1960s that we could really figure out what was going on. And Feynman and her collaborators were the first to do so. In 1977, they used 14 years worth of satellite data to show that there was a close link between the intensity of geomagnetic activity, such as auroras, and the speed of the charged particles streaming from the sun, known as the solar wind. The most activity and the most dazzling auroras always happened during the most tumultuous times on the sun. So there was no longer any question that auroras were caused by the sun. And armed with that insight, Feynman was able to gain a greater understanding of the sun's long-term patterns. See, previous researchers had noticed that the sun goes through an 11-year cycle of high and low activity, caused by a switching of the sun's north and south poles. But there also seemed to be a longer 88-year cycle running underneath the shorter one. For about half of that cycle, the peaks and troughs in the solar activity seemed to rise. Then, for the next half of that cycle, all the peaks and troughs seemed to fall. But we didn't exactly have solar data going back for hundreds of years, so it was a little hard to verify. Instead, in the late 1970s and early 80s, Feynman and other researchers used historical observations of auroras to figure out what the sun's activity was like at different points in time. They knew that when the sun is more active, it makes more brighter auroras happen further from the poles. So they could infer when it was most active based on recorded observations of auroras. And through this method, they were able to confirm that the 88-year cycle really exists. Aside from being generally interesting, that's also helpful to know because the sun's activity can have a big impact on us here on Earth. A rush of charged particles can disrupt our telecommunications and electrical systems. Like, during a peak of solar activity in 1989, a burst of hot plasma from the sun caused a 12-hour blackout for all of Quebec. So understanding those patterns can help us be better prepared. But Feynman's later research suggests that there are even more ways the sun's activity affects us here on Earth. In 2006, Feynman's knack for finding patterns led her to discover a connection between solar activity and the water level of the Nile. It just so happens that people living by the Nile kept very close track of this river for many centuries. Because of this, there are good records of its water levels for almost 1,000 years, between 622 and 1470 CE. And when Feynman and her collaborators matched that up with historical aurora records from the same time period, they found a surprising correlation. Both the patterns of the auroras and the water levels in the Nile aligned with an 88-year cycle. When the sun was active and there was lots of auroras, the water levels were low. When it was less active, the water levels were higher. It may sound far-fetched, but there's a good physical reason to believe it's real. In the 1990s, other researchers used modern climate models to show how variations in UV light could mess with the balance of ozone in Earth's upper atmosphere. That, in turn, could affect temperature patterns and cause ripple effects that could influence the overall climate. And Feynman and her collaborators found that increased solar activity could affect a certain climate pattern called the Northern Annular mode, leading to decreased rainfall in Africa. So not only did Feynman help us understand the colorful light shows in the northern and southern skies, she also made great leaps in understanding the star we live beside and its connection to our lives. Joan Feynman died in July of 2020. But thanks to her decades of work and endless curiosity, she left us with a new appreciation and understanding of our place in the natural world. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow Space, and a special thanks to everyone who supports us, whether it's by joining our Patreon community or by staying curious about the world. We're here because of all of you. And if you'd like to learn how you can support SciShow, you can find out more at patreon.com/scishow.